Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Miloš Đukić. I come from the University of Berkeley, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering, and the title of the paper is Towards Unified and Practical Industrial Model for Prediction of Hydrogen Embrittlement and Damaging Skills. Presentation contains background about hydrogen-related multi-scale approach, next, coexistence of hydrogen embrittlement mechanisms, then, objective concept of structure integrity model, results of discussion, and finally, conclusions. Hydrogen embrittlement is still extremely interesting topic, particularly still, and we must say that there is still no predictive physical model that can be used in industrial plants. Let's say that recent research, particularly new one, clearly indicates that it's more feasible that metal several hydrogen embrittlement mechanisms operate simultaneously, but that one of them dominates under specific conditions. We can see here the historical overview of approach to hydrogen embrittlement study, from micro approach using during middle decades of the 20th century to micro measure approach during the late decades of the 20th century up to most contemporary nanoatomic approach based on very sophisticated models and experimental techniques, including multi-scale modeling, of course, density function theory, molecular dynamics simulation, principle calculation, and nanomechanical testing. What's interesting about multi-scale approach? Multi-scale approach is used for hydrogen embrittlement phenomenon analysis, modeling simulation on micro, nano, and atomic level. In order to reveal the small-scale behavior of different metallic material under hydrogen embrittlement, but it's important to know that we have a very large time and spatial scale gap, which provide a problem when we want to translate these results of small-scale behavior based on modeling and to implement on mechanical response of the materials, which is important for prediction and maintenance, and it's mainly based on the effects of hydrogen hardness, strength, ductility, and usual micro characteristics. While mechanism, the most important decohesion and health mechanism, and also a large polarization of opinions in our literature, we have a proponent of health mechanism and also a health mechanism, and disagreement between different research of which one is important. It's very important to note we have here a recent literature about coexistence of decohesion and health mechanism. Most of these models are based on modeling and on simulation, while the recent ones is connected with real industrial components where we prove the coexistence of these two mechanisms and published in recent papers. So coexistence of different mechanisms is very important. Establish structure integrity model. What's the idea? The idea of structure integrity model is to provide missing link between phenomenological research of hydrogen metal interaction damage mechanism and to provide practical integrity industrial model to link micro behavior with micro behavior. Very briefly, we have water tubes damaged during exploitation, we have hydrogen damage, and as a result, post mortem, we have a very immune saturation in the vicinity. So we have real life hydrogenation of water tube that's provided a background for multi-scale structure integrity model based on correlation between micromechanism based on scanning electron microscopy and micromechanical behavior of strength. So that's provided results for definition of critical hydrogen concentration and also the measures for predictive maintenance of industrial compounds. This is the boiler tube damaged. Here we have a special non-standard subsize Roman specimen used for qualification of mechanical properties. This is steel. It's a very common low carbon fluoride steel, ST-Vadeset 1020. We have a chemical composition, and what's important, we have hydrogen concentration different at different distance. The highest concentration is near the window type fracture, so different specimen for sharp investigation have a different concentration of hydrogen. Results in discussion, here's the variation of the impact strength at crack propagation and initiation components as a function of recurrence of shadows, as in shown feature below. As we can see, we have a sharp transition from ductile to brittle behavior at some hardness value, which corresponds to some critical hydrogen concentration, and we have a very large drop in input strength. Blue one is a crack propagation component. We use the instrumental sharp machine, so we can calculate crack initiation and crack propagation components. That's happening in the case of S3 and S4 specimen. We will investigate microstructural features of this specimen. S4, S5 is a relatively good. They have good values, as you see, but we can have here quasi-clear structural features, pretty undefined, but under larger scale, we can see that that fracture feature consists of a mix of transgranular and microwave coalescence fractures. We have here the results of input strength, of the hardness of the specimen, and correlate that with the microwave mechanism of hydrogen. We can see the coexistence of mechanisms. Degradation would help in this case. It's characterized by a distinct mixed mode, which consists of a particular area fractured by transgranular fractures and also a particular microwave coalescence area. As you can see, we have the same situation on both regions, but as we can see, when we have a dominance of health mechanism, relatively high values of mechanical properties, we have a dominance of MVC in conversion with transgranular. The same fracture features, but here we have a much more transgranular areas, while we have still remaining area fractured by microwave coalescence, which are plasticity related failure mechanism. We have a transition, and the cohesion mechanism became dominant, and also TG is much larger than MVC, so we have sharp ductile to brittle transition when we have dominance of head mechanism. As you can see, the difference in hardness of these two specimens is very low. It's very close, 164 and 166. So more details about this is published in our previous paper published in Engineering Analysis and Corrosion. So if you're interested about the mechanism, you can read that in our papers. And let's see the model for structure integrity. This is the last specimen with very low hardness value. As you can see, also we have change here in microcracks and intergranular and transgranular fracture features as a result of activity of high temperature hydrogen tech, some kind of microstructure degradation in the vicinity of window type fracture, as you can see in the earlier pictures. Here is the results necessary for establishing a practical industrial model. We can have here specimens, mean hardness, or data about mechanical fracture modeling features characterized and also coexistence mechanism. As you can see, we have in the case of S3 and S4 the coexistence of the help mechanism and the occasion mechanism, while in this case help is dominant, and in this case it's head dominant, which causes the sharp ductile to brittle failure transition. And here is the structure integrity model. It's very it's not easy to explain in such a short time, but just briefly, we have two characteristic values of hydrogen concentration, hydrogen concentration low, where we have a start of the drop of micromechanical characteristics, in this case, input strength, and also the most important propagation component of input stress, while the initiation component is relatively constant, and also we can define the critical hydrogen concentration when we have this drop. What's the idea? You can investigate the specimen from industrial driven system to make the same diagram. You have a reference diagram like this, and to provide that experimental results of the new specimen should fail in the zone 1, which means run decision from the preventive maintenance opinion, critical zone, which means that you should repair your water treatment system in that part. And if you have a replace decision, you are in zone 3, where we have two different criteria. First criteria is a critical drop of crack propagation energy, but most important criteria is when your propagation energy component is below initiation component energy. As you can see, KCVT is smaller than KCVR. This is the alert that you are in a critical energy place for. And here is the conclusion: correlations between microstructure, photographic observations, and micromechanical testing data are used to propose a structural integrity model for prediction of hydrogen embrittlement and damage in steels, enabling a range predictive maintenance of industrial printing systems. Simultaneous action of both mechanisms help whose duplication mechanisms were confirmed depending on the water concentration of hydrogen in plain carbon steel after the actual operation of components and met only as usual through only simulating or modeling. We have here the real components destroyed during this rotation. The proposed structural integrity model is practical for use as a predictive maintenance in thermal block plants and other industrial plants since it is based on the use of standard micromechanical tests and the future development of unified practical industrial model regarding the implementation of necessary measurements of critical hydrogen concentration and further quantification of synergy between these two opposing things and opposing hydrogen embrittlement mechanism will be the subject of our further researches. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Miros, for this very interesting presentation. The paper is open for discussion. Any comments or questions? Please, Grigori, you first.
It is known that tests impact stress. These tests are not sensitive to hydrogen, because no time to move hydrogen during loading, and then loading to pressure zone. Yes. Therefore, for example, usually the drug touch specimens, but not to the level that you will get damage during charging. Not if you have damage, of course, you will feel this this effect, but you will not feel the effect of hydrogen during impact stress test. Yes. And you test real, from real metal specimens, yes. And you feel effect. It means that during service, your metal was damaged during hydrogenation. Really, you detect level of damage, not hydrogen concentration, but level of damage. Am I right?
It's not an important question.
Absolutely. Recent research showed that impact strength testing could be used, we write a paper about that, for a definition of hydrogen brittle mechanisms. Albeit there is a belief that it's a high-speed test where there is no time for, let's say, dislocation movements and everything else regarding cultural atmosphere and so on. You know that theory, absolutely, but recent papers show that data used like this can be used for prediction and for estimation of hydrogen embrittlement mechanism in all carbon steel. So that's the background for our usage. And the same question was also in Norway when Professor Barnes asked me, and I provide the same answer to him in Norway about that. Regarding the second part, Professor Metropolitan, what is the second?
No, I think yeah. Well, okay. My opinion, so it's interesting. Very well answered. Why? Very good question and very good answer.
We need a very usual method, which is not complicated to make on components. And these results show that we can detect the ductile-to-brittle transition. And also, these results were not the results of microstructure degradation, because we made a very careful estimation of all area in the vicinity. We have high temperature hydrogen tech in very limited area because we're making metallographic investigation, so we have halogenation, which is a result after high temperature hydrogen tech. During cooling, we have a halogenation of components, so we made this provide us to detect the viable mechanism post-mortem. After the hydrogen damage, we have a halogenation of material in real life, which is not the cause of damage. In this case, high temperature hydrogen tech caused the destruction of boiler tubes, but after a while we investigate hydrogen mechanisms.
In discussion, I just literally citing the great Professor Bill Gerberitz, I would say it's a very complicated problem. I think everybody agrees with it.
It's any other unusual special experimental group. concept applies, so I will explain everything to you.
Any other, maybe final, please final questions in this system?
Do you have any idea what is a critical hydrogen concentration and why in this particular example you have such a sharp transition between different specimens?
We have to provide the results because we must investigate the specimen import strength. If we made the dehydrogenation and calculate the content, we haven't specimen for further investigation. In this case, we haven't calculated or shown the results of a particular specimen and its concentration. It's typical that the cohesion mechanism is connected rational to investigate that 10, 5, 15 years ago, that transition from that activation of hydrogen and cohesion mechanism is usually followed by a very sharp drop in mechanical characteristics. Not only this, but other mechanical characteristics. While help mechanism is operating at different concentration of hydrogen, so when you reach the high level of hydrogen concentration, this is the model of our unified coexistence of these two mechanisms, then you have appearance of hydrogen deprecation mechanism at very defined critical hydrogen concentration, which is typical for particular steel and for particular experimental conditions. It's different, very different problem to estimate the rationale to circle that, to estimate what's the critical hydrogen concentration for particular type of steel.
Okay, then thank you again.